Hey folks, Jake Von Slatt here. This is part two of the Pentayurt build. This is the Hexayurt from last year, and I'm going to be reusing the door from that. I'm also going to be putting in the windows for the Pentayurt and cutting in the furnace filters for ventilation. So stay tuned, that's what we're doing today. You can see an example of where the paint flaked at the movable joints. Overall, it held pretty well, but right at the point where the panels flexed, the paint didn't flex enough. And that's why we had to loop with the tweezers, like I said earlier. The idea was to cover the Hexayurt tape with paint to protect it from the ultraviolet, rather than put layers and layers of, or rows and rows of aluminized tape over each of the joints. The aluminized tape that I had was 2 inches wide, and the joints were as much as 6 inches wide, so that would have been a lot of tape, a lot of taping. And we tried to do it with paint, and that didn't work. You might have been able to get away with like one of those flexible spray fusion paint formulations, but I used Kills primer on this, and it proved not to be sufficiently flexible, even though it is a latex primer. These panels are not going to go to waste. They're going to form the end caps of the greenhouse that I'm going to build for our garden sometime after the burn. These Hexayurt panels will still find a use around here. Overall, I was really happy with this door design. It worked really well. This is an aluminum piano hinge from a screen door. I reinforced and made a flange on the panel with this acrylic mirror material. I used some foam tape to make a seal around the inside, and this is another piece of acrylic to make a window. And I made a plug for the window so you could close it to all light. And all in all, it worked very well. The components are all glued together with silicone caulking, and then the door, the panel itself, is reinforced with strips of steel suspended ceiling trim. So there's a piece along the top here, there's another piece along the top of the opening, there's a piece for the threshold, and then a piece along the bottom, and that makes this whole panel very rigid. This is often a weak spot on Hexayurts, as you can see, reinforcing it with that steel makes it very rugged. So I'll be doing the same thing. I cut the whole door out because I'm going to use this as a template to cut the hole in the Pentayurt so that this will fit. What I'm not sure of is if I used any adhesive here. So it will be interesting when I remove these screws, are they? Ah, okay. So it looks like what I did was I used self-drilling, self-tapping screws, screwed through that piano hinge, and then with the angle grinder with a cutting disc on it, I lopped off the back of those screws. So I'll probably use the same attachment method, since that worked quite well, and I'll be able to reuse everything. And for the surface of the door, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to cover the whole surface of the door with that blue Mylar tape so it matches the joints and seams on the Pentayurt. So, onward! I'm also planning on reusing the Luarn plywood box that this was in. And since the Pentayurt is 10 inches high versus 12 inches high when fully stacked. I am hoping that I can use that additional space to put in components for a monkey hut. But I have to actually build the monkey hut and see if I can get away with 8-foot legs rather than the 10-foot default legs. I want to make sure the overhead doesn't come down too far. If I can, that, pardon me, if I can, then I can put all the components for the monkey hut in the empty space in the crate for the hexayard, which will be cool. Fly dust. Apparently what I used to attach the hinge to the inside of the panel was some 3M VHB double sticky tape. VHB stands for very high bond. So basically I'm going to have to rip that off of the panel and then clean up the hinge. But I want to be careful not to disrupt the door shape, since that's going to be my template for cutting the new door hole in the pentayard. So on this model, the blue lines are the ones that get taped together on plyo. This will be the tight hinge on the roof. This is the loose hinge on the roof. This is the joint between the roof and the base. And these are the places where the base is joined together. So I think that what I want is to configure this so this will be the wall up against which I'll put my air mattress. And then I want to do some cross ventilation, so I'm going to do a window here and a window here. And I think I'm going to do the door here. Actually, because of the way the door opens, it's going to have to go here, because it opens inward and swings around this way. This wall will have a panel for ventilation. We use these furnace filters set into the wall. And then the other furnace filter, I think I'll put over the bed. So actually, I think I'll put the furnace filter over the bed here, and then this one will go low down near the floor. Though I'm not sure it makes any difference. Usually you want one higher because warm air flows up, but I don't know that there's any real advantage to that on the ply. I think wind is far more important than heat flow due to striation of temperature. So I'm going to put them both higher up here. I think that will be structurally better. Okay, so the door is going to go on the right-hand panel, the left-hand side of the right-hand panel of the two panel set. I'm working inside today because it is 90 degrees outside and incredibly humid. So there's an air conditioner in the other room. It's keeping the humidity down in here, not really the temperature. But it's going to be a little tight working with a 16-foot long section of wall in this space. So that's why you're going to see some machinations here. Now, before I cut this out, I'm going to go find some of the reinforcing metal angles for the top and bottom to strengthen this. I only had a little bit of this suspended ceiling trim, and I don't really want to run out to the store to get some more, so I'm going to use this half-inch aluminum angle iron that I have in stock. This stuff's more expensive, but the fact that I have it and I don't have to run out and get it means I'm going to go ahead and use it. This is the 3M VHB tape that I mentioned earlier, and I'm going to use this to initially stick the door hinge to the foam panel, and then I'll put those screws in that you saw earlier. This stuff forms the strongest bond when it's left to sit a while with pressure on it. It is sticky tape, but the longer you can hold it together tightly, the better the bond will be. So now I'm going to screw in the door hinge, and I'm using these 1.5-inch self-drilling sheet metal screws, and these plexiglass washers. Now, I made these simply by running a hole saw through a sheet of plexiglass, but they work very well for distributing the screw head's force on the foam. Alright, I'm going to finish up this section of wall, but first I want to give you a closer look at the way the door attaches. So this is a hinge from a screen door, which I believe it was part of the door. No, it was pop riveted on, so I had to remove the pop rivets to get off the door. And what I've done is put a strip of 3M very high bond double sticky tape down the back, and then I set the door in place, put some weights on it to secure it so that the VHB could set. And then I shot these self-drilling screws with a large plexiglass washer on them through the panel and through the aluminum
and then I cut the backs off with my Dremel tool. And that will make a very nice connection. Now the door itself is from last year, and it's a piece of panel. I've cut a circular hole for a window out of the center, and I made a plug so that we could completely darken the place. But actually, it turns out the tint film that I've put on the windows is sufficient, so that that turned out not to really be necessary. The frame of the door is basically just acrylic mirror material, and it's just glued on there with silicone seal, and then I've rounded the edges, and it's just four separate pieces. So pretty simple. On the other side, I made a couple of small pieces of the acrylic mirror stuff. These are where the handles will go through, the 3D printed handles, and I'll show you those a little bit later when I do a test assembly. That may actually be in part three of this series. And then there's some sticky foam tape to form a seal when you close the door. And when the door's held closed by the 3D printed handles, it seals up quite tightly. No dust got in last year. Well, there's always some dust, of course. Ply of dust gets in everywhere, but it was not a major inundation. All right, I am going to finish taping the other side. This is the furnace filter for fresh air, and there'll be another one of these on the other side so that there'll always be some flow of fresh air through the yurt. That's important to get humidity out so the air stays dry and you stay comfortable, particularly if you're using some sort of mister or swamp cooler. I am not going to try to use a swamp cooler this year. I tried one last year, and it didn't work too well. It made the inside of the hexayurt very humid, much like it is today here in Massachusetts. And it was less comfortable than simply being in the shade of the yurt with the windows open and the dry air of Black Rock City flowing past. What was very helpful were little battery-operated fans. So I have some slightly improved ones I'm going to bring this year. So I'm going to tape up the other side of this furnace filter, and then these panels will be done for now.
I don't have any LPs to use as a template, but I do have this laser disc of the island of Dr. Moreau. I felt like this filter was too big. I found a couple of these at the dump, and they're good filters, but they're larger than I wanted. So for over the bed, I cut this down to about 1 feet, 1 foot by, 25 inches, I think. And I think this will be a better fit. I'm kind of figuring this out as I go along. I want some sort of hinge for the window, and then I'm going to need some sort of clasp. But it all has to pack flat when I fold up the pentayurt. So I think I'm going to make some sort of tape hinge along the top, and then I'll probably use some sort of magnetic clasp to hold the window closed. That'll probably just involve gluing some magnets and some steel to the inside of the yurt. But I'm still kind of figuring it out. This is some shielding tape that's a lot like the tape that I covered the hexayurt tape with, but it has a thicker mylar coating and it has an aggressive adhesive. And I think it may do the job for the windows. I think I'm going to use a layer of this and then I'm going to put a layer of hexayurt tape over it to reinforce it. This is a bit of an experiment. Last year, I just used hexayurt tape, and the adhesive softens in the heat, and I was having some issues with the hinges not staying together. So we'll see how this works. You can separate the magnet from the backing by putting it into a vise and carefully, very carefully, working the blade underneath it and splitting away the epoxy that holds it down.
Okay, so here's what I decided to do for the window. It's a piece of plexiglass, and then I put a mirrored film on it. This is automotive window tinting film. It passes 5% of the light, and it has a mirror finish on both sides. So the other side of the porthole is just a mirrored circle. Then what I did was I put some weather stripping around it in a square, and then I made a hinge with this mylar tape. You could probably use regular aluminum tape or the hexayurt tape. I have had the hexayurt tape let go. The adhesive seems to soften when it gets hot, but I suspect that the aluminum tape would work fine. The advantage of the Mylar aluminum tape is it's a little tougher and it won't fatigue like just the straight aluminum tape will. Duct tape might also do the trick too. And then with the same tape, I put these computer hard drive magnets, four of them, around the outside. And then more of these little neodymium magnets. I bought 100 of these little things on eBay a while ago, and they seem to do the trick on the inside. And that holds the window sealed at the top and the bottom against the inside of the pentayurt very nicely. Now, one thing I did add, the tape hinge at the top tends to tighten up, so I took a piece of 1/8-inch brazing rod and I taped that along the inside of the window, and that forms a little fulcrum that pulls that top tape hinge out so that the window doesn't bow forward. And this seems to be working pretty well. I'm pretty happy with this. I will, when we're on Playa, I will add a magnet to the top edge so that when we flip it up against the roof, it holds the window open. But I'm not going to do that until I have the yurt actually set up. So now I'm going to do the other window, and then we'll be done for today.
And that's it for Pentayurt Part 2. Next weekend, I will set it up and cut the tarp for the bottom and make sure everything fits correctly and just make sure it's all ready for the playa. And then I'll package it up in the box you saw earlier take it to the Boston burning truck, which is how I'll actually get it out there. I'm in Massachusetts here, and of course Black Rock City is in Nevada. So each year a bunch of the Boston burners get together and rent three or four shipping containers, load them with all their stuff, and they go on a train, they head out to Gerlach, and then they're shipped onto the playa to the Boston Hive, which is the big Boston village. So I will be putting all my stuff there and heading out to Reno on a jet plane. Hope to see you there. This is Jake Von Slatt. See you on the playa.